Hey y'all, Sarah Madras here, founder of Esteem Builders Coaching. I am a motivational speaker and a licensed relationship therapist. I am on a mission to ignite a cultural revolution to fulfill our human need for truthful connection and belonging. Now, how do I do this? I do this by teaching you the interpersonal skills so that you can have success and fulfillment in your personal and professional lives. Today, I'm going to be talking about overfunctioning versus underfunctioning. Which one are you? Or do you teeter-totter back and forth between the two? So we're going to find out how. So overfunctioning is essentially like, think of it when you're in the workplace. Let's say someone who overfunctions is super type A. They are prepared all the time. They're constantly like checking things off their to-do list, super organized. They don't procrastinate and they get things done. And you can give them a project and you know it's going to be taken care of and they're going to go above and beyond. They kind of like to control things and don't like to delegate and may even micromanage. So and bosses and management who are overfunctioners, they will then micromanage their team, okay? If you are underfunctioning, then that means that you kind of avoid. It's that whole stick your head in the sand and everything will be okay. And if I just put on my earmuffs, you know, it's that whole, if I don't see you, you don't see me kind of a thing. And they leave things to the last minute. They procrastinate. Things fall through the cracks. Things aren't getting done. Deadlines are being missed. And that's underfunctioning. And so before I learned about where overfunctioning and underfunctioning comes from, I'm going to be honest with you. In my mind, I was like, well, woohoo, the overfunctioners are the rock stars. They're the strong ones that persevere and they get things done no matter how hard it is. And the underfunctioners, they must just be lazy and they're weak and they give up too easily and they don't think about how their choices affect others. And well, like, hello, that's because I'm, you know, hi, my name is Sarah Madras and I am an overfunctioner. Like I need to be an overfunctioner as anonymous. And so it came with all this judgment of overfunctioning is good and underfunctioning is bad. And then I learned that overfunctioning and underfunctioning is actually just a result of anxiety. So when we are in a heightened anxious state, when we're overwhelmed, we fall into one of those camps, right? And we either get overwhelmed and shut our brain off and are like, I can't deal with this, la, 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 and shove our head in the sand and miss deadlines. Or, you know, instead of getting things done, we're binge watching shows on Netflix and stuff like that when we're anxious. And same thing for overfunctioners. They overfunction and try to control everything and try to get, you know, micromanage everybody when they're feeling anxious. And so when I look at it of, oh, this is just a result of them being anxious and the result of the anxiety, then I can look through a place of compassion of let me help soothe the anxiety rather than yelling at the person for being lazy. So, you know, management teams out there, if you're looking at somebody and you're like, why are they underfunctioning? It's probably because they're really anxious right now and they're overwhelmed, not because they're lazy, not because they don't care about the job or they don't care about what you think as their boss and they're trying to be disrespectful. It's they're stuck and frozen and underfunctioning due to anxiety. And so it's then as the manager of that team and as that leader of that team of how can I help soothe this, like how can I help ease this person's anxiety so they can get back into the game again, so that they can start producing, so that they can start engaging and being a part of our team. And for overfunctioners, leaders of the overfunctioners, it's, oh, they are micromanaging everybody and they're staying here to all hours of the night and burning the candle at both ends because they're anxious that something might fall through their cracks. They're anxious that they won't get, you know, their promotion or whatever. And how can I ease those anxieties so that they can be back in the game and be part of the team again? So we can have a cohesive team versus the overfunctioner over here controlling and yelling at everybody, and the underfunctioner who's over here going, oh my God, I can't deal with this and I have to run away and I'm going to call in sick for the next 2 days. And so once as a leader, you realize what's really going on underneath, and then it's not about being, you know, oh, strong and or oh, controlling versus weak and giving up. It's about the anxiety, and let's address that so that then our team can be cohesive and productive and resilient together. Because when your team is strong together, you produce better results. So ask yourself, when I am feeling like I'm overfunctioning, that is my red flag that I am anxious, that I am under a lot of stress, and I need to address the stress and anxiety instead of continuing to overfunction or instead of continuing to underfunction. That I just need to stop, take a breath, and deal with the anxiety and the stress to reduce that, to take care of myself, to have self-care and better boundaries, so that then you can be a better team in the workplace and you can better be a better teammate at home. Okay? All right, that's it for now. If you would like me to come in and introduce these concepts and teach these workshops to your team and to your leadership teams at your organization, just shoot me an email or visit my website at sarahmadras.com. Thanks so much. Until next time.